Emulation started, hooray. Hello everybody, I am FTA.
I'm a Kunis fan.
And I'm a Donnie.
And we're here for a special LP of a terrible game, Dr. Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine, Dr. Robotnik's MBM. And as a special guest for this part, we have the one and only MBM for MBM.
Yay!
Konnichiwa, bitches.
So, this game's terrible, get that right off the bat. It's just been a common theme the last few LPs we've done for FTC have just been terrible games.
So, you guys are like a Sonic fan site thing, and now you're coming to the realization that you LP shitty games?
Whoa. I agree. Now this is it's pretty unique in the fact that this is the only game that's 100% based off an American Sonic cartoon. As we have here, we have the Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog designs for Dr. Robotnik, and there's of course Scratch and Grounder, and it looks like Dr. Robotnik is currently having a stroke for some reason. Okay.
He's dancing, man. He's grooving.
He's like Milton Knight is rolling around in his grave, God rest his soul. Look what they've done to his amazing creation. And apparently Scratch and Grounder can just disintegrate. Okay. good to know.
Was that always Robotnik's motivation to get rid of music and fun?
There is actually an episode where he does create a robot to remove all of the music from Mobius. So this is true to the AOSTH canon. Good job, team. Good job.
Yep.
Fucking evil.
This game was recorded by Donnie because I don't have the patience to play this game. So Donnie just joined FTCR, and as penance for him always forgetting to mention FTCR whenever he talks about shit, I made him record this crappy game.
Yep, and plus I kind of it helps knowing that when it comes to this game, I'm kind of quick to beat it. It only took me, I think, an hour to beat this, so it's only a few parts.
And I'm sure everyone who's watching this can see this is obviously it's a clone, basically, of Puyo Puyo Panic. Is that how you pronounce it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sure.
Sure, why not? Which I'm not sure why. I mean, I guess at this point, Sonic was so big of all the cartoons and the comic that Sega thought we can make kids buy this if we just slap Sonic's face on it. Which is a marketing decision that Sega have done countless times now, so good job.
Fuck you, Arms.
I think it has more to do with Puyo Puyo, because they did the exact same thing with the SNES game. They turned into Kirby's Avalanche.
Yes, they did!
Then Pokemon Puzzle League is Puyo Puyo, isn't it?
No, Pokemon Puzzle League is the game you play on your calculator.
What?
Go to college, you'll know what we're talking about.
No! So, Donnie, can you describe how to win? Because I never got this game.
That's how you win the game. You don't get this game.
I win!
Hooray!
Fuck you!
LP over! Let's get rip-roaring drunk!
Way ahead of you.
Yeah, but the way to win this game is essentially you just have to match four beans. It's sort of like Tetris in a way, except Tetris is better. And I say better specifically for one reason alone. You don't have the dickish computers, and also you go to bed with nightmares seeing some of these expressions that the characters make. So, yeah, good job. But
yeah, this dude alone is freaking me out.
Was he in the cartoon?
I think some of these are based off some of the robots, like the first boss. That's a robot from one of the episodes. I think some of these are. Some of these are just bad
original
designs.
Character.
Yeah,
original the robot.
Do not steal. Like these are poor excuse for Mega Man villains. It's just terrible. But I forget. Is it ever explained? Like, who are we controlling, Donnie? Are we controlling Sonic? Is Sonic the one playing against his robots, or is it just random person?
Basically, who you're controlling is. Do you see on the score, like the score area, a little orange figure, like giving a little blankish expression?
Yeah.
The Pichu right there?
Yeah, that is who you're playing as. A character
what?
Called Has-Been.
Has-Been? Oh my. I get it.
That just describes all of our YouTube careers. Pretty much.
So guess what? We're playing as our YouTube careers.
So why? I guess. So who? Like, who is this person? Where did he come from? What's he doing? I don't get it.
He's from Puyo Puyo. He's actually called Carbuncle in the Puyo Puyo games, I think.
You shitting me? Carbuncle. That's amazing.
That's like the one holdover from the series, I guess.
Well, there's apparently some. There's some of the audio tracks on here, if you hack it, that are from the original Puyo Puyo.
Well, yeah, because like, it's the exact same game. They just changed, like, you know, some of the sprites to make it fit into the AOSTH world. Which is, okay, whatevs. But, Donnie, so I guess the way you win is that you just have to last longer than your opponent.
Yeah, and basically trip them up so it'll help them, you know, lose.
Yeah, I take it that if you get two combos at once, you put blocks in your opponent's columns.
Yeah, and boy, do those rocks become like an absolute thorn in your side, especially in the ladder levels, because they just come down all the time.
Can you match any color with them, or?
Yeah, any combo works as long as they're an actual, like, valid match, so.
Hmm.
Aren't the blocks called refugee? They're like refugees because you're trying to save these jelly people, I guess. And you're making them blow up. And then you save them.
Yeah, and...
Good job.
What?
So essentially, we can only bring freedom to this race of being creatures by committing mass genocide. Interesting.
Way to go, Sonic.
Yeah, fuck you, Sonic. Why aren't you in Knuckles Chaotix, you bastard? But seriously, though, Hasbeen is actually a mutated being that was already converted because of Dr. Robotnik's little mischief, so... Essentially, Hasbeen is the product of what we're kind of doing right now, so he's essentially making more of him.
He's the mean bean.
Oh, shit, son.
He's trying to fuck up the machine.
He's a Robotnik... robot that was already, like, roboticized, and then he still kept his will, and now he's rebelling against Robotnik?
I guess,
That's badass!
There's some Proto-Man shit right there.
That expression he's making is just beautiful, by the way. Is that even supposed to be an expression?
Yes.
I wasn't paying attention during the opening cutscene, Eggman's plan is just to, use these beans just to...
It's Shrek!
It's Michelangelo from the recent Ninja Turtle film, genius. So basically, Eggman, Robotnik just wants to, like, capture these beans to ruin Mobius. Okay.
Yeah, for having fun, I believe it was.
You gotta admit, the guy has a pretty efficient game plan here. He's taking his enemies and eliminating them by turning them into his own army. It's twofold. It's actually pretty genius. I gotta give him credit for that.
Why is Coconut's only boss 4-4? He deserves to be much higher up. Coconut was always my favorite of Robotnik's robots.
Yeah, and he's the start of the very, very awkward expressions too. I can't remember if I actually do show that expression off, but oh my god, it is just priceless. Like all the a lot of the expressions here just make you wonder what the hell are they thinking when they're about to beat you. But it creeps me out, and yet at the same time it's just hilarious just because of how outrageous they are. This game trumps Sonic Adventure in terms of expressions, and that's saying a lot. Oh no, I obviously. No, you don't get to see the expression because I fuck his shit up right here, so.
They should re-release this, but. Jesus, Mike, you destroyed Coconuts! they should re-release this, but put, like, the Sonic Boom robot, so they have to fight, like, Burnbot and shit. I'd play that game. I would. No, that's a lie, I wouldn't play that.
Let's not. Hey, it's Patrick!
Patrick.
Patrick Pig.
What is this thing? Oh.
Something that gives me a very, very awkward thoughts right now.
He's a screw!
Seeing as they, I haven't played the original Puyo Puyo apart from like 5 minutes. Like, is the music original for this, or did they just use the Puyo Puyo music?
The music is original for this. It's just the beans aren't. They make it sound like the beans are different, but really they're the Puyo Puyos, essentially. So, just with a different like background.
Yeah, I remember them from Sega Superstars Tennis.
Yeah.
Mm. They're the exact same Puyo sprites in Kirby's Avalanche.
So I wonder, like, so I take it Sega and Nintendo, like, is Puyo Puyo just like a royalty-free game that anyone can just release?
It's been mostly a Japan-only game, so.
Because if so, let's make us an FTCR one. We'll make this, but we'll just have different sprites for, like, now you have to face MBM and he starts throwing shit at you. It'd be amazing.
Just fuck your shit up. Like, what's that? You didn't beat my level in 5 seconds? Get the fuck out of here!
Sonic Boom Shadow is the final boss.
Oh my god, yes.
I'm just curious about one thing. If MBM is playing Mean Bean Machine, does that mean he's technically playing with himself?
Oh yeah.
I've been doing that this whole playthrough.
This LP just got a lot better.
What the hell is this?
Oh!
What the
What Crippled Patrick?
Is this the Mean Bean Machine? I paid $10 for a physical copy of this game last month. What was I thinking?
I told you not to, but we walked into that store. I was like, why are you buying Mean Bean Machine? It was like,
I gotta own them all!
Gotta bean them all, Robotnik.
Robotnik.
I like how he just doesn't give a shit, his expression.
Because he knows what game he's
in. I could win, I could lose. I wanted to be in Spinball.
That is a sad statement when you'd rather be in Sonic Spinball than this. Oh my god. Which I would say, so Donnie, you play a lot of Spinball and you play a lot of this. Now obviously they are technically two different games, you know. Which one would you say do you find yourself coming back to, and which one would you say is the better game?
I have a lot more fun playing Spinball. I don't really rage at Spinball compared to Mean Bean Machine, where I have had a history of raging because of the fucking computers. But yeah. And you'll see very quickly just how bad they can get.
You're losing. Donnie, you're losing! You're losing, Donnie!
Hey, it's as if I knew I was playing the game.
Oh, they're angels.
Yep.
Thank you so much for keeping this in, Donnie.
He had to show off the death animation.
And then you skip past it in 2 seconds.
Show that Christianity is canon.
In the
this
Sonic
is 100%
universe.
Complete let's play of Sonic.
Christianity is canon. So all of those bad Sonic fan arts when they have like shadows praying by a grave, it's canon. It's completely true in the Sonic universe.
Thank you, Mean Bean Machine, for solving that problem.
Or the one where there's Shadow with the Chow with really muscular and is in a thong.
Yep. It's all canon. It all makes complete sense. Pray for beans.
Yeah, look how I'm doing. Look how I'm doing the very next run. I've already gotten him up to the tough. What the hell did I do differently here compared to the last time?
Hashtag typical puzzle game.
It's called this game just is trolling me, I guess.
The most I ever played this game, there was an achievement on the Sega Genesis Collection for the Xbox 360 and PlayStation 3 for beating this game. So I just did a level select and went to the final stage to beat it for the achievement.
You scrub.
Oh my god, this game. I hate it.
What's sad, I did the exact same thing, except in Sonic Mega Collection.
Well, blow me away!
I don't want to blow you anywhere, what the hell?
As if Dr. R hasn't had enough stick already. Whoa. I know what this guy's for.
I didn't know it was this kind of game.
Look what it looks like.
MBM just got a lot more interested in this game now.
And you said it's how much on eBay? Been holding out on me.
Wait, you're on MBM, you're on eBay? I could purchase you?
I'm going to snipe at the last second and win the auction.
Chris can buy me. Donnie, you're not allowed to bid on this sweet ass.
Yes.
So you, like, it, I mean, the fact that the background for every level is the same, and it's like the same thing. Like, I imagine they probably, with the exception of the music, they probably had this game finished, like converted from Puyo Puyo to this in, like, I'm gonna guess about 2 hours.
Yeah, I think the game came out in like 1993, so it would make sense to say we're working on a certain other Sonic game at that time, but yeah,
Sonic Spinball.
It sounds like it was very converted. Like, they didn't really do too much with this, but I mean, hey, at least we got the expressions.
Donnie, I noticed one thing. There are certain times when, like, there is like a clear win for you, but you opt not to like. So say if you have three beans on blue and you have a blue one, you don't always go for the automatic points. Why is that? Is that your strategy, or are you just, you're blind when you play this?
That is my strategy. What I'm trying to do is I'm constantly trying to get combos, because that is pretty much the only way the computers are going to go down, is by just bombarding them with these stones. And because if you notice, every time I've won, it's because I've bombarded them with them. And like I said, you can only do that by getting combos, so that's what I usually do in this game, is just constantly try to get combos. And unfortunately, it doesn't all go according to plan, like it sort of isn't here.
I love that Sonic's not in this game at all.
He's not even in the name of the game.
Well, you know, at this point, he kind of did. Actually, no, he did, because all the Game Gear game sucks, and he had no standards.
2 years into existence, he had some, maybe.
Well, because after CD came out, he clearly had no standards. But that's because at this point, Sega were up for making games that Sonic went in, like, you know, Tails Adventure, Tails Sky Patrol.
I forget those exist.
Yeah, everyone tries to. I mean, like, Sonic appears in like the final screen of Knuckles Chaotix, but he ain't in that game. I guess like at this point, especially after Shadow the Hedgehog, I don't think we'll ever get a game set in the Sonic universe that doesn't feature Sonic himself. Which is a shame, because
that face.
I've always... Oh, Jesus Christ, Donnie. I played this game.
It sucks, because
I've been wanting a Knuckles Streets of Rage for years now.
Yeah, it's...
Bare Knuckle.
Bare Knuckle, yeah! Bare Knuckle 4 featuring Knuckles the Echidna. Fingers the Echidna, whatever.
It looks painful to beat these bean guys. Like, you connect them and their faces are all stretched out before they explode by the sweet release of death.
And they make a very, very cheerful sound when they die, too.
Well, it's a pitiful existence. I'd be happy to die, too.
What is going on?
There's more ambiguity in all these games. It's assisted suicide, and then the angels come, and then Sonic prays for all. That's where Sonic is. He's busy praying for the souls of all these beans.
Hashtag pray for beans.
Yeah, this game is just euthanasia the game.
Oh, nice combo, Donnie.
Yep, like I said, it's really helps having combos like that. Because look how much I filled up his play area by getting that combo.
Man, that pump guy was really excited about losing before he just exploded.
That's
right
what
there.
I'm saying. Like that guy.
Yeah,
he got the climax.
Pretty much, you know, he was touching himself. What the hell?
He really enjoyed it.
Why is ground? Why is ground?
You can call me Sam.
I'm like a superstar. What the hell? Why is Grounder so early for?
Oh.
Why is Grounder such an early boss?
I don't know.
I think they wanted to sprinkle the more familiar characters just throughout the game.
Yeah. Especially considering another familiar character is coming up very soon. So.
They should have put Robotnik Jr. in it.
And he makes some great faces.
What now?
What?
Just MBM going, what now?
What? You guys can't talk about this shit like it's casual and everyone knows it. I'm so confused right now. Why was I even invited to this? You fucker said this was Pokemon Puzzle Challenge. I'm so lied, dude. I gotta sit through this garbage.
So, MBM, have you ever even heard of this game before?
Yes. And I, oh, well, okay, I knew about it before MBM, but...
Grounder is so high right now.
I need my smokes.
Let's all take a cue. Why aren't we?
We should follow Grounder's example. Do you think the developers were just like, we know this game is a cheap cash in, but let's just make the robot faces look as messed up as possible?
It's the only actual original work they put in, I would.
Yeah.
Shit, at least have some pride, Sega.
Yeah, speaking of messed up faces.
Donnie, did you leave in every death?
Yeah, because I didn't really, it's a very quick...
He's just like me!
Donnie, answer me one question, one question.
Huh?
Is this only gonna be one part, or do I have to sit through more of this bullshit again?
If Donnie knew how to edit, this would only be one part. Good job, Don.
I think the next part is like a good 15 minutes, so.
Get in.
So based on everyone's experience so far, I mean, this game just looks like something that you'd play and complete and then very rarely ever touch again. You know?
You were good until you said play.
What puts me off, I just really don't like the tile background and the stone thing. It just doesn't make me want to look at it. If it was something bright and colorful, I'd probably want to play this game every now and again.
It's like, I don't get why they didn't just give each like different robot you face like a different background. I mean, it couldn't have taken them that long to make, you know?
That would have helped too.
Or, you know, make some backgrounds that look like Robotnik's factory base type deal.
And I can't believe we don't get one instance of dun 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 dun. Fuck this game. Like the greatest Robotnik theme of all time when you guys don't even use it, dicks.
There is a tune that does appear later on when you actually do fight Robotnik, but I don't believe it was that, so... Unfortunately. It would be nice, though.
I hope it has porn guitars.
The best Robotnik themes always have... Donnie, are you gonna lose again?
I think I do, because I have no matches here, and I have nothing to...
Jesus!
Jeez, Don!
This is the most I think I actually do... This is the most I believe I do fail in this game, though.
I blame myself for allowing Donnie
it's
to record
fault.
This LP!
Donnie, what did we say? This is part of your job description!
Donnie, your internet fired!
I feel bad because when we had Ryan on the Lost World OP, we made a bunch of brain scratch shows because the editing was so bad. But like, we're just as bad as they are now. We don't fucking edit shit anymore.
Jeez, just gonna spend an entire 15 minutes in one room, right? Right?
This is, oh my god, what is going on? So, you know what? We have a few minutes to kill. I had the most messed up dream last night, right? I had a dream that the Sonic movie came out. But like, literally, for some reason, the first half an hour was just scenes from Superbad, like, edited together. And then the last hour was like, really bad. You know that like, Pakistani, like, Happy Meal commercial? Like, the CG looked like that. And
oh,
there
God.
Was no character voices. It was just like, it was just a single narrator explaining what was going on over the course
Dude.
Of the film.
That's totally Aaron's fault, because he was talking about Strong Bad last night before we all went off to bed.
Emmy in Rogue Tennis.
So I'm like, that is what I'm
Fuck
hoping.
Aaron.
That's what I'm hoping the Sonic movie is. Just scenes from Superbad, and then the Pakistani Happy Meal commercial CG. I'd watch it.
I would rather be watching a playthrough of a game involving Pakistani Sonic than this.
Okay, that when you said Superbad, I thought you meant Strong Bad, so I...
Yeah, you're an idiot. Shut up, Chris.
This game does things to me.
I love how we haven't even been, like, we're 25 minutes in. Yeah, we finally beat him. Or I hope.
Our curse is lifted. We live to see another boss.
How does a robot sweat?
Let me show you. Domo arigato fisto lobato.
Oh.
Domo. Domo.
There is nothing more.
So, Don, would you say this game is...
How is he not gone yet?
Would you say this game is actually challenging or just kind of cheap sometimes?
It's a mixture of both, really. I think the computers can be very cheap, but at the same time, it does test your skills as well, because you really do need to make sure you concentrate very hard and stuff like that, but yeah.
Thank Christ this part is over!